We are entering in to see their activities. And here is the leader of the group, O Towedi.
Yeah, so Gang Kilok happens to be a subgroup under Towedi. As the pastor has already said, my name is Aokiria Alfred. I'm the group, the project leader for Towedi. So we have some activities which are going in here, going on in as far as the Gang Kilok women's group is concerned. So we can visit them. Yeah, we have to treat the legs before we enter.
Here you find that this small room here, where these birds are still confined, is called the brooder. When the birds are from day one to at least 14 days, we keep them in a small room called the brooder. In the brooder, you find the heaters. For example, this lamp here for lightening and heating sometimes. We also have pots down there, and those pots will be providing some heat. And these other containers here are drinkers, where we put the water mixed with the medicine for the kids to drink. Uh-huh. So you see she's adding up the drinkers. That. And then these other small containers are called the feeders. That's where we add the feeds. So I think, madam, you have your feeds, Lilo. Do the feeds and be adding in this other box. Okay? 500. And expect them to keep alive and eating these feeds for the past 3 months. After the first 3 months, we can change the feeds. As you may look behind there, those bags there are the feeds we have. We call them chick and duck mash. So after the first 3 months, the feeds will change to what we call the grower's mash. After that, we then move to layer's mash. Actually, these chicks here are only layers, they are for eggs. And we expect them to start laying eggs after 4 months from now. So, these are the birds which Gang Kilok keeps in order to raise funds for their group. But you'll find that this space may not be enough to keep them. But we expect to expand the other places so that we have the birds free.
And you need a lot of fresh air, a lot of light, that's why we have a lot of windows around here, which are open.
Yeah. So this kind of what the activity is taking place here. After 1 week from, I mean after 2 weeks from that confinement, we allow them freely to come in here to other spaces. Yes, we have a lot of challenges. One of them is the expenses of the food. Actually, each of these sacks here is a 70 kilogram sack of feeds, and one of it costs 45,000 Uganda shillings. So that is really a challenge. So we scratch our pockets seriously to buy this, but sometimes it's not enough. Two, we need another challenge is the little room we have. But we hope this room will be expanded. And of course, expansion of this room will definitely need some financial implications, which is also a constraint, of course, to the group. The other challenge will be to get the market for the products which will come out of this bird, for example, the eggs. The market will be available, but of course it might be an overflooded what? Market. Okay. So those are the challenges. We have the we would be able to keep more than 1,000 birds, but of course, because of the financial constraints, we cannot go beyond that. That's why we decided to begin with the 500 birds, because of the little financial resources which we have.
What about sickness? What kind of sickness attacks them?
Yes, the disease is called Newcastle disease. But fortunately, that disease, we normally give a vaccine called NCD. NCD vaccine is given after everyone, from day one of the hatching. Then day 7, we give another vaccine. Day 14, we give another vaccine. And then day 21, we give another vaccine. So basically, we give about 4 vaccines. That vaccine is called Newcastle disease vaccine.
So far.
And of course, it's very expensive. So far, we have given only one.
You have 500 of them?
Yes.
Are they all still alive?
Oh, when we brought them, whether I like them or not, they must die. So, since this is day 5 of this bird, so already we have lost 5 of them also.
5 of them?
Yes. So 5 have died so far, but still they will continue dying. And but of course we expect the number not to, to be very alarming, yes, as the care seems to be a little fair.
Yeah. How do you try to prevent the end of life?
Normally what you do is you limit the entrance of persons to this room. Actually, when you put the seats, there are no-go zones. If any couple comes in, we have to dip our legs in the elements at the door,
and that will prevent transmission of any infection from outside to the other parts inside here.
Now, how do you prevent the local chicks and maybe the local ones from entering to mix that?
You will make sure the door is permanently closed. That's why you see these windows, there's no entrance. You cannot let it, they're all wires. And the door must be closed permanently at close attention so that no any other foreign bird can come here. Because they are very sensitive even to foreign, I mean to wild birds, rather than the domestic ones. They are very, very sensitive to this.
Yeah, you say these pots are for lighting?
Yeah, these pots we put here charcoal and then put some light here so that it stays overnight. They will be heating the room. Actually, the room is very, very hot at night. This bird must be kept at about 42 degrees Celsius.
Now, how do you measure the temperature? Because I see you put pots here, I see you put light there. Don't you think that is one of the challenges?
Yes. Yeah, of course, we'd have liked to use the electricity which has got its own measurement, but because we can't afford the electricity in our villages here, so we use the pot. We estimate that a certain amount of heat is enough for them. And we also observe them, when we see them happy, it means the heat is enough. But when you see them squeezed,
yes,
the heat is little. So we raise it according to how you observe their behavior.
Thank you.
The time of 4.5 months when they start laying, that's when we shall expect the laying rates to rise up gradually. It gives by about 6% at 4.5 months.
Yes.
Then when it reaches to 5 months, it grows about 60% laying rates.
Yes.
When it goes to about 5 months, 5.5, that's when maximum is. In other words, since these are 500 birds, we shall expect each bird to have one egg per day when they are 5 months. So that's about 500 eggs per day. And 500 may give us something close to 4 trays, 5 trays.
No,
about 20 trays.
That is 30 eggs per tray.
Yeah, 30 eggs per tray. So when we reach maximum, we expect to get about 20 trays per day. And that earning will make us something like, because each tray is about 5,000 here in Uganda, so you'll find that will earn us some good money, like 5,000 times the other one will give you what?
That is around 100,000.
Yes, per year. Yes, per day. So in a week we expect to earn about 700,000. Hmm? In a week.
Oh yes.
So in a month, 2.1 million. So you can see, we are very hopeful about it, yeah, if all goes well. Thank you.
Now, Egan Kiliok, how many members do you have in your group?
First of all, Egan Kiliok, the word Egan Kiliok simply means to give supplementary help to the husbands.
Yes.
So the idea that 25 members who are females, then about 3 who are men.
Yes.
Yeah. The 3 men are playing an advisory role. Otherwise, basically for women.
The group is basically for women.
Basically for women. Yes.
Now, why did these women begin up this idea?
No, they saw the challenges they had in the houses. The household income was not very comfortable for men alone to handle. So they said the women came together and handled themselves and put up the small resources to begin several projects so that they can also supplement the pockets of the men, the husbands, in order to earn a living in their houses.
Yes. That was the major reason why this group, Egan Kiliok Women's Group, was started.
Yes, to supplement the efforts of the men.
Yeah. She's here and she's representing the chairperson who is sick for the group of foster parents. In their group, this is one of the activities they are keeping the turkeys. And one of the activities is again the collecting money and then sort of savings and loaning, and then they give to each member in the group. The reason why they started giving money today, giving money in tons, it is because they saw the problems in their own families, and they started they developed this idea to help their families and then to educate their children. Their major problem, even if they are trying to raise up the turkeys, but still they have a problem. They don't have a place where they keep these turkeys. And the money that is given in tons to the members is not enough to sustain the life in a family. So it is very difficult even to increase this activity here of keeping the turkeys. This one's also the turkeys when they hatch. They also need enough heat and proper care because they are also delicate to handle. Whenever they hatch, it's very difficult when they are, to keep them when they are still chicks, and you find that as such, many of them die. Actually, we appeal for help if it will be possible for us to raise where we can be keeping them. In their group, there are about 20 of them in the group. That is foster parents as 20 members. They are mixed men, both men and women. Yeah. So I saw some of these birds. They had legs that what happens? Why do they walk like that? Legs are... What happens?
So that they lack food, and that is where the problem is, because they are kept in a squeezed place and they don't get enough food, so that is the cause of it. So what are the challenges that you're being faced with? Is it easier to keep them? Actually, it is very difficult because they need a fenced place where these turkeys can be kept. So, you mean to say you need a house? So, actually, they needed a house that can be put in the partition, rooms can be put in, where the young ones can be kept, and then those ones that have grown a little bit like this size can also be kept in another side, so that they can be free. She was saying that this is where they always keep the young ones when they hatch. And just as you can see, the place is very, very squished. So many of the chicks die. So there's no way they can provide enough heat because the place is very squished. So those where they can be kept again, just the same as this one. So this is one of the problems she's trying to tell us, that it is because of lack of food. These birds don't get enough food. That's why you can see they are lame, and they need enough food to eat. And these ones, they are lacking food now. When they grow, that's where they can be kept. So when they grow, we normally set them just to now to walk openly, and then as a result, sometimes they are stolen, because when they get out there, they are always stolen from outside. So she said that they need enough house where these things could be housed and kept, and then they need a fence where these things could be kept, because just as we've been saying, that many of them get lost always, can be stolen from outside. When you set them to walk, to move freely, they are stolen always. And our request is a house, be if it is possible. We really need a house and a wire where we can keep these turkeys for safety. And we know once we are helped like that, we can be able to sustain our families and educate our children. And we also need the funds to make us, actually to enable us buy food and...